the sun announces another day of hope, to lives empowered by the will and the means to change. Even in this harsh land, life can be beyond survival. This is Patan district, bordering the Little Run of Kutch in Gujarat. The villages here have saline lands that are prone to droughts. There have been cyclones and even an earthquake. But below the brown can be seeds of green. That's what Self-Employed Women's Association, SEWA, has learnt. The members of SEWA have grappled crisis throughout their lives, and they've learned to seize the opportunity tucked in every problem. All they needed was to get organized and get empowered. Traditional skills and existing resources have churned out alternate livelihood means for 2,15,000 women. They've learned to make their own lives better and clear the way for others as well. That's Savita Ben's story. As the chair of the Village Development Committee, Savita Ben works for the growth of her village and its resources. But these forward-looking eyes did not always think about the greater good. She hardly had the means to fend for herself. Coming from one of the poorest families, she worked as a casual laborer on others' lands. Meena Ben, a leader at SEWA, invited her to participate. Her first thought was just to be able to feed herself.
પછી મેનાબેન પાછા મારી ઘરે આવ્યા એટલે કે તું મને એક ફેરો મળી હતી ને તો કહેતી હતી કે તારે સેવાનું કામ કરવું છે એટલે મેં કહ્યું કરવું છે પણ મને મજૂરી મળે તો
મેનાબેન કેપ્ટ ધ પ્રોમિસ ટુ ગિવ હર એન ઇન્કમ બટ નોટ બાય મેકિંગ હર ડિપેન્ડન્ટ ઓન અનધર શી ઇન્વાઇટેડ સવિતા બેન ટુ એક્સપ્લોર વિથ હર ન્યુઅર પાર્ટ્સ ઓફ લાઇવલીહુડ મેનાબેન ફર્સ્ટ ઇમ્પાર્ટેડ સેવાસ ફિલોસોફી ઓફ બિલ્ડિંગ વન સેલ્ફ then building others. Savita Ben garnered skills in income generation activities such as compost production and raising saplings. And all along, she was trained to lead others like her. No longer at the mercy of men, fate and rain, they lead to empower their communities as well. So, their confident faces are etched on the path of their village's progress. These women owned no land, but today raise plants for many lands. SEWA has over 1,000 women raising 35 lakh saplings a year. This is done alongside seed collection, grafting and processing. So, traditional wisdom of land and plants molds into modern nursery skills, triggering not only eco-regeneration, but also economic regeneration. 1,000 erstwhile poor houses now have secure livelihood. A similar harnessing of traditional know-how has been achieved in salt farming. They were farmers and laborers at salt pans. Today, 35,000 of them have organized into a federation. They've adapted scientific farming alongside testing and marketing of iodized salt. Their half-yearly income totals 25,000 rupees. Here, another age-old produce is marketed for contemporary demand. As part of Rudi, agri commodities are procured from 200 villages and sold in 1,500 villages. Members earn up to 3,000 rupees, while farmers gain an additional 100 on every 20 kilo they sell. The demand for SEWA's innovative products is not just within the country. These traditional embroidery motifs have traveled continents in novel forms. the women have also acquired what would have seemed unlikely skills, from assembling bicycles and repairing hand pumps to trading in light bulbs. After the earthquake of 2001, reconstruction became a challenge and yet an opportunity. 1,500 men and women were trained to be masons. They specialized in building techniques and manufacturing materials that were quake resistant. They formed their own construction and building materials association that obtained contracts from companies and builders. But when women take on to build their world, there's often ridicule for tilting the norm.
Pehla to ase pramuk jay pehla to apna kan majuri karta tha to pramuk chamse pramuk apni hasi kare.
Today the women have the last laugh. The landlord who once employed Savita Ben participates with her in village meetings. Here women with men decide on development and livelihood issues. Savita Bain's and Meena Bain's walk has now gathered strength. And with strength comes humility. The hands that edify the village sweep the dirt and disease off its streets. As part of the Paryavaran Mandal or Environment Committee, Savita Bain and others maintain hygiene and sanitation, an important concern in rural societies. In these societies, there's also resistance to participate in such efforts because of social stigma and caste prejudice. But Meena Bain and Savita Bain, along with SEWA, untiringly pursued. Today, there are Paryavaran Mandals in 75 villages. The entire village cooperates in the cleaning. Malaria and other diseases have now reduced to almost zero. SEWA's cleaning cooperative supported the effort by providing tools and training to them. The gathered waste is used for an important income activity, compost production. Vermi compost provides an income of 1,60,000 rupees, that with an investment of just 84,000. Vermi compost also benefits the village land, making it more productive and promoting organic farming. While the march is gathering momentum, it turns to imbibe the changing times. The hands that knew little more than daily chores are now armed with modern technology and communication techniques. This is one of the 35 centers established by SEWA to train rural youth in using information and communication technology to aid employment. These have further developed into community learning and business resource centers. Here, villagers access telemedicine, teleagriculture, as well as electrical and other business services. While they keep up with the present, they also strive to better the future. A new generation is being equipped with the lessons of today. Along with supporting education, the women inculcate values of cleanliness. They also pitch for the nourishment of children. In this way, they've not only built their own lives, but are also facilitating the process for others. That is the essence of empowerment.
Our main thrust is that, you know, the policy makers need to really think on how does one ensure livelihood security, and also setting up a livelihood security task force. We also have the National Rural Employment Guarantee Program, which are the types of economic activities which could also be a part of these kind of, you know, governmental programs and schemes, so that it generates, you know, helps in ecological regeneration as well as into economic regeneration of the regions.
Empowerment has not just meant a defeat of poverty, but also provided myriad solutions. Organized as economic associations, women have been able to initiate and sustain livelihood alternatives. And these have not been simply viable, but also fully profitable. But it has been, and will still be, a constant challenge to upscale these initiatives and support them with apt resources.
બેનોને અમારો એક શક્તિ એટલી દેવાની છે કે જેવા અમે અમારું કીધે અમે હોશિયાર થયા છે ને અમે અમારા શક્તિ છે કે અમારે કંઈક કરીને બતાવવું છે એવું બીજી બહેનોને પણ કહેવું છે તમે પણ કરી બતાવો અને તમે પણ આટલો શક્તિ વિકાસ કરો.
Though determined, this stride is young and yet to realize its full potential. But the path is paved to include more. This call is not just to women like her. It's an open invitation to participate in different ways.